Hi folks, Rick Berube here, Vice President of Sales for Berkshire Hathaway Home Services of Arizona, California, and Nevada. And look, hey, congratulations. We are at the end of the first quarter. We're beginning the second quarter of the year. So if you're where you want to be, congratulations. If you're not, well, the good news is you still have 75% of the year ahead of you to do that. So I want to talk about some points to maximize, okay, and really rock the second quarter of the year. First one is, in real estate, you can't afford to be average. There's no such thing. For the National Association of Realtors say that if you're average, you're going to make about 30 grand this year. Yeah, $30,000. It does not sound exciting to most of us. A lot of you, most of you I talk to, your goal is at least 5-10 times that. Okay, so average is unacceptable in the real estate business. All right, so how do you become above average? Well, first thing is you got to be trained. Okay, we have wonderful training here at Berkshire Hathaway. We have success series going on all the time. We have coaching going all the time. Get involved, okay? That's an important one. And even when you're not, you know, the coaching and the training, you still can be audiobooks. And there's so many different things you can do to keep your mindset in the right place to really maximize the second half of the second quarter of the year. Okay, next one is, and I think this is a big one, the competition for you is only in the mirror. That's the competition. What you're looking back at you is your competition. Okay, a lot of people tell me, I lost this deal to that person. No, you didn't. Okay, you lost it to yourself. So you are only competing against yourself. Stop comparing yourself to other people too and just maximize what you can do in a day. That's what makes you feel great anyway, is maximizing your potential. Okay, next one is, I wrote down is, conquer the fears you have. We all have those little fears inside, okay, like talking to people. When I do our call clinics on Saturdays here at the St. Rose office or in Arizona, I am shocked at how afraid of prospecting some people are. But when they come and show up, I gotta congratulate them because then they make breakthroughs and then they start being able to talk to people. Look, you're in the sales business. You can't be a secret agent. You have to talk to people. Okay, I don't care whether it's on the phone or face to face, you gotta do that. As a matter of fact, that's my next point, is you have to master the art of conversation. The best way to do that is talk about anything but yourself. It's hard for a lot of salespeople. It was really tough for me at first too. You have to talk about other people. You know, why are you moving? How long have you been here? Where do you folks want to go? Dig deep on and get really into what's important to them, their motivations and so forth, which is also the next point. Build connections with people. You build connections by keeping the conversation about them and then staying in touch with them after. You put the house under contract, you guys, once it closes, these are customers or clients for life. The National Association of Realtors say that 78% of you will never talk to your client again after a closing. That's shocking. That's where that residual income comes in, by continuing to build those connections and keep them going. Okay? My other point here I wrote down is, you have to set your work hours at the beginning of the week. I love people say, well, you know, I was texting till 11 o'clock at night with a client. 11 o'clock, I've been sleeping for 2 hours by then. Okay? There is not, you just set expectations up front. I'm gonna come in at this time, I'm gonna go home at that time, and I'm gonna work in between. Okay, that's the critical part. Decide where those are, okay? The other thing is, and my last point, or my second to the last point for today is, failure and rejection are part of the process. If you're not failing and you're not being rejected, you're not trying enough. Anybody can go through life not failing. If you don't try anything, the result is guaranteed, you won't fail. You also won't get anywhere. Rejection is not bad in selling, it's necessary. Rejection is part of life, driving your car, going to the gym, flying in a plane, air over the wing at a certain speed causes lift. Rejection is part of it. Resistance is part of life. In selling, we just call it rejection. All right, and then my last point today is reward yourself. And I'm not talking about just for listings and sales. I'm talking about for taking the right action. Long weekends, vacations, all that stuff is important as long as you're doing the other ones. Okay, thanks for listening. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.